Welcome back. So let's get straight into installing a virtual signal. A virtual signal is a signal that exists in iTrain only and so is not a real physical device located on your layout. Virtual signals are useful to have on your switchboard because they show us what iTrain is seeing and therefore can be helpful in identifying problems. When a train is in a block, we do have a kind of virtual signal in the throttle here, which shows what iTrain is seeing. But it is a general signal and not a regional signal, and it only appears when a train is in a block. So we can't see any signal indications elsewhere on the layout unless we place signals on the switchboard. We are in iTrain 5.1 here, and the switchboard is showing the entry into a yard ladder. We will see the reason for this gap later. The train is facing direction next, and the general signal is showing a red aspect. It is effectively telling us what the signal aspect would be if one were placed just before this turnout. So this signal is giving us an indication of what iTrain thinks the train is seeing. If I change the direction of the train, the signal changes to this red stop square, indicating a terminated track ahead. I haven't placed any more track on this section yet, which is why that is showing. But you'd see this similar signal displayed when the train enters a terminated siding like this, with a buffer stop on the end. When the train is approaching the yard, so in this direction, we want to see a home signal located here and a regional signal showing in the throttle instead of this general signal. So let's open the switchboard editor and install the signal. Select the location where we want to install it, then press the delete key to remove the existing track element. Then in the right hand menu here, right click on the general signal and then select the regional signals appropriate for your layout. I use British signals, which are installed on the left side of the track in the direction of travel, so different to most continental signals. With British signals selected, I now see the various British signals displayed here. I will use this home signal 3 aspect. So select it by clicking on it, then use the R or the T key to rotate it for the correct orientation where we're going to place it. And then either double click on the item to install it, or you could press the space bar. Whenever you make changes to the switchboard, it is good practice to follow the 5 steps I'm about to show you. because it helps to ensure that everything is correctly entered, assigned, and connected. After the item has been inserted, step one is to define the object. Step two, group it. Step three, autofill the blocks. Step four, press the connect button. And step five is diagnosis. So after saving and exiting from the switchboard, run the diagnostics. And remember to save after each step, or at least at regular intervals. Adhering to this five-step approach will lessen the chance of missing something and save time in the long run. So that is all for this tutorial. In the next episode, we complete the first three steps: define, group, and autofill. So until then, bye for now.